Singers like Ma Rainey, did they ever appear in the places where you played with Oliver in the clubs?
Not at the Lincoln Gardens. Yeah. They didn't. I mean, they,
but at theaters and
they always in the theaters, yeah. And the crowds stand around the corner to get in.
Yeah.
Like Bessie Smith, Mamie Smith, and Clara Smith, yeah. Miss Barnes, what is her name? She was she made this Good Time Flat Blues. Well, they always had their own band, like Coleman Hawkins. He used to play with Mamie Smith.
Well, then when they started to make these records, and you made a whole series of records accompanying singers, how did they bring you in? Did they heard you and had
yeah? Well, I got that break when I was with Fletch Henderson, yeah. You know. We at the Roadland.
Yeah.
And we would go down like one day to trombone, clarinet, then the cornet, then one day all three of us.
Yeah.
And Dixon on the banjo. And we made our little extra change like that.
Uh-huh.
But they never did appear with like King Oliver.
Was she was it a different kind of musical thing that you had to do to accompany a singer than to?
No, just play the blues.
Just play the blues.
And fill in them gaps.
Answer her back.
Yeah. That's what we call the spots, you know.
Did she have these things planned out as regular tunes? Did you?
Well, she probably had her blues. Yeah. You know, sometime like Bessie Smith, I remember she'd just stay in the studio and write the blues as she finished one, just write another one.
Huh?
Yeah. And all we gotta do is wait till she finished. That's the like, my man don't love me no more, and then we da da do da da fill it. It was nice though. Yeah.
Did Bessie come from R.L.Gleason? Is that where she came from as a singer?
Well, I don't know who was first. R.L.Gleason had been singing a long time. Mm. Big heavy set gal, you know.
And big woman.
Yeah, I think Bessie came a little later and outsang them all. Chippy Hill, yeah. He's played with them. I played with them all.
Sippy Wallace.
Sippy Wallace, yeah. You know them all, don't you?
Well, play in the Oliver Band and then to go on and play with Fletcher Henderson things, and right in the middle of all that, you made such a remarkable series of recordings with a small group. The Louis Armstrong Hot Five, which I'm sure everyone that's listened to jazz all over the world knows of these records. And I had never noticed this until I looked them up in Charles Delaunay's discography recently, and they were all made within a relatively short period of time. And this was, to me, a very astonishing thing that such a 10-day or so period was so productive of so many classic records. I thought we could listen to one this afternoon Skidaddidat, which was made in Chicago in 1926, in which your Hot Five, your own group, these were your first combo records with your own group.
My own group, yeah.
Louis Armstrong's Hot Five and Skidaddidat.